greatest gift ever.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Because you did this tonight?
Happy birthday, Greg Sterling.
From now on, I'm only going to point poop gun.
Happy birthday to.
Okay, Norma Jean. You. Is that what you're going to do during the monologue?
On this auspicious occasion, the anniversary of the birth of Greg Sterlace, we come here not to bury Greg, although at times it is tempting, but to honor him. Needless to say, if it were not for Greg Sterlace, there would be no Greg Sterlace show. And then perhaps it would be the Gwen Keir show, but let's not go there now. Today we say happy birthday, Mr. President, and may we say that it is amazing that you are still here among the living after being hunted by angry lesbians, local rock legends, and most recently threatened by members of the press who shall remain nameless in case there is a lawsuit pending. We're happy you survived, because if you don't, our lives would be duller and lack the elements of shock, outrage, and self-indulgent comedy to which we return each week after bloody week, live and still furiously kicking from the home of the future. It's the Greg Sterlace Show, starring Greg Sterlace, the man, the legend, the myth, the ball buster, the heart attack waiting to happen, the hunka-hunka burning love, the solid ball of angst, the clown, the poet, the bionic man, the hunchback of Notre Dame, the world, and welcome to it, the Big Bang, the super duper pooper scooper.
You're on.
I still can't hear myself. Okay, I can barely hear myself. Turn that air conditioner off.
Go. Hey.
It's cold.
It's freezing.
I'm cold.
Anyways, this is a very exciting show.
You're wearing a hoochie.
Am I really on?
You're wearing a hoochie mama.
And,
that's why.
We've only got five more weeks of this show, and that's all over. Mary, we decided.
Got Mary on the show.
We decided since the caliber of the guests, such as yourself, is going downhill.
Hi, San Francisco.
We're gonna. Don't you mean Austin?
Austin, Texas.
Don't you mean Austin,
Texas?
Hey, Bubba.
Hey, Bubba. Anyways.
So Mary thinks I'm hoochie.
Since the quality of the guests is going downhill.
You're the heat.
I.e. Mary. We're gonna stop doing the show. We got five more shows left, and I really want to have this show be the 30th, April 30th show, have all the people here, but we're doing it 4 weeks early. What about that, Gwen?
I'm wearing a bathing suit that show.
You always do. When do you not wear a bathing suit?
That would
be. You wear a bathing suit right now.
Baby pool of water and jump
I'm going to have a real hoochie mama outfit on that day.
And I'd like to apologize to anyone that I said Gwen's breasts were small. They're very big, as you can see here. They're C.
She's flat chested.
Good point, I know! Just like you!
Wait, you need a bra, mister.
Yeah, I know. I need a bra.
Yeah, you have some big hooters
Greg,
let's check out my breasts right now. Oh! My mother's here. My mother's here.
I hate that when you do that.
My mother's here, but she won't come on. So since she won't come on, at the floor of protest,
Mary,
I'm going to flap my nipples. Yeah. Next guest. Okay, Mary, get the next guest here.
Peace, people.
This is an exciting night here, isn't it? How do you feel?
I feel good. I feel excited.
So I hear you're leaving in a few weeks to go do a play.
Yeah, and he won't let me do extras, guys. So
anyways,
call in and say you want me to do something.
Paul, you're going to be filling in for Gwen while she's gone,
right? Paula's going to be the co-host.
I don't want to get involved in this, thank you.
Okay.
God, it's so nice to see you
again.
Paula, thanks for setting this up here tonight.
I'll tell you all the things I'm going to let you do from now on.
Ready?
Because you set this beautiful birthday night up for me with 80 of my favorite, you know, jerk off
acquaintances. For she's a jolly good fellow, for she's a jolly good fellow.
All the people I hate, all the people I like slightly, all the homosexuals. All the tall rock critics, you know what I'm saying? My parents, not
everybody
my,
that he doesn't
not my brothers.
See.
And I'll tell you the things I'm gonna let you do from now on.
Okay.
Number one, you can call me Poopka.
Woohoo!
That's what you love doing.
Poopka.
Number two, this does not involve Gwen at all. This does not involve Gwen in one bit.
But I'm involved.
You're always fucking involved. You can touch me, but not Gwen, though. Gwen's never touched me ever
again.
Oh, my God,
I can touch you?
Well, you did all this beautiful thing here for me. We're getting married, aren't we?
That's right.
Three, we're getting married.
Getting married.
In August.
Now, listen. Is it with Tony Bellani? Are we going to get married with them?
I know that I didn't.
It's going to be a twin wedding.
I proposed to you last night.
I didn't hear you.
I didn't.
She hasn't said yes yet.
You said yes, though, right?
Okay. Hey.
I want to marry you. Come on, baby. Let's go.
You got to hold her hand. Hold her hand.
I want to marry you. Come on, baby. Let's go.
Was that at Mohawk?
I want to marry you. Let's go, baby. Yeah.
The union of two beautiful people.
Is this a beautiful ring I got for her or what? Look at this. Look at this. Look at this MF. It's pretty big, isn't it? So here's the ring. Look at that baby. It's big. Ooh. It's very big. It's like Red Rose Speedway.
Wait a minute. What hand is
it? It's going to have to be on your thumb.
It's going to be on this hand.
Will you marry me, Paula?
And when I go away, you know my heart will stay with my love. It's understood. It's in the hands of my love. And my love doesn't come to me. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Is it my segment?
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Is my segment over?
So anyways, we'll get married.
Isn't my segment over yet?
Yeah, you're over. Thanks for coming on. Here you go.
Thank
next
you.
Guest.
Next guest. It's Jill.
Jill Shanley.
Jill Shanley.
The person I hate more than anybody else in the world. Thank God she's here. Jill, good to have you on.
Jill, I don't know why he does that all.
Jill, I love you. You're so good.
I love you too.
It's nice to have you
back.
You
broke my heart just now.
Well, yeah, I know. But you're already married, though.
Does it? Yeah, you already are married.
We
remember when you got married.
State, you know, it's
you know, I all these years, I want to have you on here because I want to ask you a lot of important questions. Like, are you... Now, are you a freak or are you just weird?
Right? You broke my heart.
You broke my heart.
You broke my heart.
You're not gonna keep saying that over and over again.
You broke my heart.
How did I break your heart?
You just proposed to Paula.
But you're married to Billy Bob Thornton. You know the
redneck.
Yeah,
you're happier with Billy.
Jill, what are you doing?
Jill, you're happier
Jill,
with Bill.
Back to the show, Jill.
Hey.
We're on the air.
I got a birthday gift for
it's
you.
It's a birthday gift. She
all right.
Happy birthday.
Let's open this up and see what it is.
Here, Gwen, I can't. I'm too excited. I'll open it because
too excited.
No, you have to open the card.
Oh, let me see the card.
Oh,
goldfish.
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 Oh, I love them.
Oh, they're so good.
This is the best.
Can't open them. Oh, thank you. That's great. I wanted cookies, though, Jill. But hey, goldfish are.
We get you cookies every year.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I wanted to get you something different.
Let's see what the card says.
Parmesan cheese original.
Oh, there's a penny in it. There's a couple pennies. Thanks for the penny. I'm really enjoying it.
Well, you need the penny. There's lottery tickets.
Lottery tickets. Mad Dog Jill and the funny monster knows just who he wants to bring these wishes to. A very special kid. That's you. Thanks
Mad Dog
lot,
picked out the card.
Oh, look at this card. Can we get a shot of that? Look at that. It's a monster. It's a monster. Got it, Paul? See it? See the way it's moving? Keep the camera on it. Keep the camera on it, Paul. Come on, this is your
Greg,
job.
I'm playing your lottery.
Where's the penny?
So
oh,
anyways,
penny's
Jill,
over there.
You want to answer my question?
What?
Are you a big freak or are you just weird and eccentric?
You broke my heart, Greg.
That's all you're going to say?
This is the best
All right,
present.
Well, thanks for coming back. Why did you quit the show anyways? You were on doing a show here with me for 3 years.
I was working in Akron.
You were working
she was
in Akron.
Busy.
It
was
wasn't
an
anything to
hour
do with,
drive
It wasn't
way.
Anything to do with the late James Elmore?
We lost. We lost the first
the
one.
The truth comes out. Woo! Okay,
Jim Elmore,
thank you.
We have goldfish.
I want to think you went
thank
back.
Thank you
so
for coming on.
You've
that
got lottery
great.
Tickets first.
I'm sure I won. I'm a very lucky
you
person.
You lost on the first one.
Thank
Come
you.
On.
Thanks for coming on. Thanks for bringing the Budweiser for me. Can I have the rest of that? Thanks. Appreciate it.
Jill, thank
yes,
you.
Yes, I do. I started drinking ever since you came on the show. Jim, ready? Let's go. Oh, Tony. All right. We have a special superstar and his wife, Bridget. It's great to have Bridget here and Bobby. Bridget, how's it going?
Great.
You do all the talking for the couple.
It's great
to see you. So I'm thinking about
great
doing
to see you. Happy birthday.
So I just got engaged, Kimberly.
I heard we're gonna have a double wedding.
Paula,
August?
Yeah. Because see the thing is Tony told me. He said
look
to me,
at this picture. Isn't that a beautiful way?
Oh,
I gotta
let's get
in
a close up of the two of these and a Gwen too. What a bunch of crap.
We're so in love.
Anyways, yeah, right. Anyways.
All three of us.
We're all.
Give me a ménage à trois.
What's that?
Oh no, we don't want to get
Oh, you already speak Italian. I forgot. anyways, Kimberly, I was talking to Tony.
Uh-huh.
Stop playing a damn lottery and listen to me. This is the show.
Okay.
Do you know
Tony?
The world is obsessed with
I'm
lottery.
I'm not scratching
Greg.
Anything.
Yeah, no, you're not scratching. So Tony says to me, "You gotta get a beautiful Polish woman." because they love to make love all
Polish
day long.
Women are the most beautiful days, women in the world.
They're the most beautiful women in the world. Like you know, what's her name here?
Like Paula.
With the blonde.
Like
right,
what?
Paula.
Like
so,
like
you, like Kimberly, like Paula,
like Kathy,
like Donna
Kathy.
Reed. She was Polish. Not many people know that.
Uma Thurman,
Polish.
Polish. Definitely Polish.
Sharon Stone, Gwyneth Paltrow, also Polish.
Marilyn
Monroe was Polish.
And they all play lottery.
Right.
They all play lotto.
Boris Karloff was Polish. David Delaney.
And get their
many of the greats.
Marilyn Monroe.
Bela
Lugosi.
And
they all eat goldfish.
Haircut from Carol.
The ampersands. Anyway, so he told me that. He said, you got to get one of these Polish ladies. I got my Polish lady.
Uh-huh.
And I said,
do
are
you ever.
Yeah. And I said, hey, this guy, this Goomba, this Goomba guy, this Goomba dude, this good buddy, this Goomba, this other WAP. I'm a WAP. He's a WAP. He's got a Polish woman. I need a Polish woman. And then it's amazing. You set up a birthday party, surprise
roll
birthday party for Tony.
Out the bell.
Am I right?
6 months
am
ago.
I right? 6 months ago to the day.
To this day.
And now I have the special birthday parties from Paula.
There you go.
Secret. Surprise.
Special.
And it's so weird because I said to her last night, let's get married, baby. And I didn't know the party. It's like the X-Files. The truth is out there.
What did she
the
say?
The goddamn
when you
truth
said,
is out there. Attica! 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 Okay, okay. All right. Thank you.
It's been
next
so
guest.
Nice,
thanks, Cam.
It's the Wrangler. Is the Wrangler on next? The Wrangler man.
I need to get implants.
You're the Marlboro man. I'm sorry.
The unknown Marlboro man.
The unknown Marlboro man.
We're doing a show.
Yeah. I'm trying to win lottery.
Can you do this later when we're doing the show? Don't think we're professional to pay attention to the guests.
Yeah.
Now, anyways, you're the Marlboro man.
Yes, I am.
The unknown Marlboro man.
Yes,
now,
I am.
Now, have you heard about the Surgeon General's warning saying that?
Yeah, but you know,
it can hurt your pregnancy.
You know what happened to me? I found
fetal syndrome.
I knew I was dead when I was coughing in my coffin.
Gwen, I think he's saying he's dead.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Of
Did
course.
You hear that?
Of course,
he said
I'm
he's dead.
He said that when he was coughing.
Of course,
he was coughing in his coffin.
I'm riding a monster in hell now.
Are you alive or are you dead?
Dead. Dead.
Really?
Dead.
So
you're
not,
you like to be
are you really
alive,
here right
is
now?
Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm the dead Marlboro man.
Is this guy a ghost? Are you a ghost?
Yeah.
You're a ghost.
It's the ghost of Marlboro's from
you
past.
You seem so full, though, and thick.
Yeah. Like a Marlboro.
Gwen, I'd like to mention something to you. See if you agree with this, you know. Usually you and I don't agree. Boy, you're so something or other.
Can I touch you yet?
No. I said no, only Paula, my wife. You can never touch me ever again. Only Poopka over there can touch me. Anyways. See, the thing is, there's this guy I know, right?
Yeah.
Listen to this, Gwen. He's the unknown poet, right?
Yeah.
It's this guy I met 2 years ago, and I had him on my show.
I met him.
Right, you met him, right?
Yep.
You've been here when he's been on him, right?
Mm-hmm.
So he's been on, like, how many times on the show? Like, 15 times?
He's only been interviewed twice, because he
But he's been on, how many times has he done poems?
That day.
How many times has he done poems on the show, though?
At least 15.
About 15 times, right? Over 2 years, right?
Yeah.
Right, so then this guy, he gets his own show, right?
Yeah.
Called The Unknown Poet Goes to Hollywood, right?
Yeah.
And he, oddly enough, even though I had him on my show 15 times in 2 years, even though I made him what he is,
I have not been on his show, right?
Even though I made him what he was.
Oh, my God!
Right, I introduced him to the guy to Richard, to Richard Wicca, who does the show for him. If he had never met me, he wouldn't have his own show, but I've never been on. Even though I was doing poetry before the unknown poet knew what poetry was. But I've never been on. But I'm here, you know what I'm saying? Have you been on a show?
Yeah.
That's on his goddamn show!
I was on the show! You haven't been on.
What do you think about that, Marlboro man? Do you think this guy should invite me on his show, maybe?
Yeah, be a partner.
Great, cool. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks, Marlboro man.
Okay, thank you.
Next!
Thank you, dude. Don't smoke, kids. Don't smoke.
Don't drink.
Don't drink.
What do you do?
You don't
smoke,
drink. Don't drink.
Smoke.
Oh, it's a tall music critic coming on.
Woo!
Tall music critic. He's
tall
not a homosexual,
music
though. No, he's hetero.
I don't think I'm doing much of anything right now.
How you
nice
doing,
to
Kevin?
See you, buddy.
I'm just great. What the?
You're here to celebrate my birthday, huh, Kevin?
He came to sit next to me.
Just to celebrate you in general, Greg. Gwen is sitting next to me.
What is so great about Gwen and I? Is it our charisma?
It's that we can't stand each other.
Charisma, Kevin?
I think it's part of that. It's part of the charisma that you can't stand each other.
Is it my looks, my beautiful looks?
It is.
It's your looks.
For but the sure. look, not
your
the
looks.
No, I said it's
look.
Your looks. It's not your beautiful looks.
No, not my beautiful. It's
your
just
look
the fact
and my
that
look.
It exists. So.
Right. No, I don't have. I'm not beautiful. I mean,
but you accept it.
I think it's beautiful.
But you accept it.
You accept
I accept
it.
The fact that I'm not
stick with me on this one, Greg.
Just like you, right?
Here a minute or two.
Just
no,
like
thanks.
You, right? Would... You also accept the fact that you're...
Hideous? Yeah.
You're not hideous. Oh, don't say that. Quinn, is he hideous?
I don't think
okay,
Kevin's
no,
hideous.
I'm not hideous.
And
no, I'm not.
And I don't think that
just
Greg
you're what,
is hideous.
Just because you're bald?
Though.
Is it because you're bald? You think
enough.
You're hideous?
No,
you look
not.
Like a monster. I got to admit. I mean,
you know,
I can see you in a monster movie just coming out of the swamp.
The thing about Kevin being bald is Kevin is bald and he's
here.
Not really bald. I mean, he's got hair. He just goes bald for the look. He's
you,
not like a balding man.
No, you, oh, you're not really bald. You do that for to be like a cool hipster, like the brothers shaving your head.
Well, because what do
you really have hair? You can have like a full
I've
head
had
of
my hair like this for about 11 years.
Yeah,
so you can have a full head of hair then.
This is his look.
Not full. The hair's thinning a bit on top. But
no,
it would
it's
be,
not,
so,
it's been,
it would
well,
be you fuller than it is now. Sure.
Oh, so you, Bobby, you shaved it because you just wanted to go for the look.
The
Frankenstein look. You weren't going for it. Wasn't because you were bald.
I tried the balds, and they don't stay in real well.
Hair with the
trepanation is that's one thing to work here. I'm sorry?
John, I need a picture of
her. There's my fiance.
There
she is.
This is what it is.
Get a shot of her.
This right here.
Oh, she's gone. Okay.
This little.
She's coming back out, though. Let's catch her in the act here.
Paula.
She can't stay in there forever.
Bride to be.
She can't stay in there forever.
Greg, no one has graduated you officially. Congratulations.
I appreciate it. Yeah, you're. We've come to our wedding this August.
I would love that.
Because we're
going to
have a reception at the Ellicott Square building because they have a swastika on the floor. And I feel as a Nazi that I should have a reception at a place that has swastikas.
Swastikas was good luck.
As
before.
A Nazi.
It's a Nazi
comes
that I am.
The bride,
so you'll come to the wedding.
I would be honored.
Oh my
how about
she's
the,
going to marry Greg.
Gwen, we're doing an interview show here. Kevin, are you excited about the Sabres playoff chances this year?
I'm not that excited. They'll make the playoffs.
Because of Hasek, it's hot. If he ever got hot, if
it's
he
electric.
Ever played the way he's played.
You know,
played
Hasek comes to Ellicottville.
I know, so does Eric Clapton.
And Eric Clapton.
And they hang out together.
Have you seen them together?
Clapton, no, she's not joking.
I'm not
know.
Joking.
I heard her say
yeah,
on the
Clapton
show.
Clapton and Hasek, yeah.
Yeah,
and,
I didn't
the
see
thing
that
is,
in Costa Rica.
You know how he said the stretches in the regular season, Kevin? That
yes.
That were so good that he was voted the best player in the league 2 years in a row.
Yes.
Not just the best goalie,
but the best player.
And then the most famous best player of all time, the great one, Gretzky, said that he's the best player. He endorsed
Gretzky.
Him, too. So
oh,
if he ever could play in the playoffs, they hit a certain point where he's as hot as he's been in certain parts of the regular seasons in the last 5 years.
He was quite good last
year.
We could. We need offense.
We can win the finals.
Yeah.
I mean, we can go to the finals and
final?
Win the cup, right?
Can
am I right?
We could, possibly.
Okay, well, check this out. Shouldn't he have won game six last year?
Of which series?
The third series, the finals, the conference
finals.
Is
that
time
no,
to
no
change?
Goalie can
but what about the
own.
Fact there were 9 minutes left and we had a one goal lead and we
I'm
lost
sorry.
It? What about
yes,
that?
Yes, you are.
I don't
yeah,
want to
Gwen,
talk
come
about
on. Talking about hockey here. Jesus Christ, hockey!
What?
Talk about music, Kevin.
Hockey! Hockey!
Music!
Not bloody Manchester United.
So it was nice having you on. Nice having you on, Kevin. I really appreciate you doing it.
Kevin,
really
I
nice
love
you.
Having
thanks.
You on. I was
next
kidding.
Next up,
oh,
the fag. Who's up next? The fag from Britain?
Oh, yeah.
Fag
Mr.
Boy?
Redhead.
Mr. Fag, Mr. Homosexual, Mr. Lie Down with the Lions. Who?
Frank.
Who's Frank?
Here
sit down
comes
put the damn
the
head.
Hair.
Sit down and put the damn headset on. We're running out of time here. How many guests we got left? About 10?
Yeah, we gotta go. Hustle.
Okay,
yeah,
give
right.
me your spiel. You got 30 yeah, right. seconds. Go.
Right, piss off or die. Oh, oi. Boy Stink Bitch's new album, More Touch, available on Wailing Cat Records.
Keep going.
USA. What? That's
USA.
It.
USA.
And
put the camera back on him. There you
and
go.
And Chelsea is the greatest football club ever.
Keep going. You weren't on camera for that. Do that
oh,
again.
Okay.
Wait. No, you're still
no,
on.
No,
you're still
no.
on. Hold on. Wait, no, you're still not on. No, here we go. Ready? Go.
Oi, get out of the way, Tart.
Tart?
Tart, T-A-R-T.
What did you call her, tit?
Oi, anyone tell you you're smuggling? Oi, you're smuggling raisins, you know.
Just put it on him. I don't want to be involved in this. Put it on. Please put the camera on him.
I'm spitting goldfish.
Back to him. Back to the fag.
Yeah. I'm going to pound Hosey's face in when I get off here.
Why? He didn't make out.
Because he
band.
Said something about football. That's why.
I heard it in Nightlife.
Yeah,
he gave a review of your band. He said they sucked the big one. Is that true?
Boy, look at oi, oi,
oh!
Look at him give me that. Oi, that's what you. Oi,
yeah, thanks
that's
for
what
being
the
on.
Plex called dishing.
Yeah.
Yeah, piss off.
Thanks for being on.
Thanks.
Max, who's next?
Hey,
who's
nice
next? God damn it. Get somebody in here, Paula. Don't just be my wife. Be my lover.
Oh,
I don't know. Dick Combs not here. Julie.
Julie.
Half of what I say is meaningless.
Okay.
You gotta talk on a headset.
I know. Okay.
Half
got
of
it.
What
Hello,
I say is meaningless.
Just half.
Anyway. But I say it just to reach you, Julie. Seashell eyes.
No, thank you.
Crazy smile calls me. So I sing a song of love. So I sing a song. So I sing a song of love for Julie. Julie, how about dumping that African American boyfriend of yours and going out with me?
That's a response.
Because you know I'm Caucasian.
What
you know what I'm saying?
Maybe
we match. We match. You know what I'm saying? He is a different color.
You know his color may be different, but I guarantee you're much.
If God thought the colors were supposed to blend together, he would have made you. You know,
he matches you know much better than you do, Greg.
Because I'm a Nazi. Did I mention that? But my Nazi heritage.
Well, I think we discussed that before, but.
Will you be at my Nazi wedding? You have to wear a swastika armband. In August.
I don't think so.
Get this! For the Nazi wedding, I'm going to invade Poland!
Nazi wedding.
I'm going to invade Poland! I'm going to march in there and take over! Yeah! It's going to be rape and pillage in Poland! You know what I'm saying? Okay, anyways, back to you, Julie. How's
okay.
it going?
Happy birthday.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Anything else
How old
you want
are
to
you?
Tell
Has anybody
I'm
asked
34.
You? 34.
Past the Jesus Christ age, so I'm in clear sailing now.
That's
for
being
honest. Want to say?
Okay, no.
It's not you, Julie.
Oh,
I love
okay,
you.
I understand. Okay, thank
I
want to
be your boyfriend.
Okay, but
you know,
can't.
On the side. You know, you'll be my mistress.
No, I don't know.
You know.
Thanks, Greg.
Listen, the night before the wedding, you yes. and I make love all night, right?
Uh-huh.
So that when Paul and I are making love, I'm,
yeah,
you know,
her
I can calm down a little bit,
because
otherwise
that.
She'll be up all night if I don't make love the night before. You know what I'm
well,
saying?
Well, as long as he can
she'll
come
be
and
like,
take
all
pictures.
Night.
If he can come and take pictures.
If he can come and take pictures, he won't.
Oh, your ex boyfriend can
take
photos.
If he can take pictures.
Porno photos?
As long as he can come.
Yeah, I can do that.
As long as he's there, fine.
I don't. But I don't endorse Adolf Hitler at all.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you for coming
okay.
on.
Okay.
We
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. You're great. I hope you enjoyed it. Oh my God, the homosexual! Call the homosexual squad! Call the vice squad! Get away from me, you faggot!
He's attacking
you goddamn
everybody!
You goddamn faggot! Stop touching me, you fag!
Touch him! Touch
you goddamn
touch
faggot!
Him.
Get off me! He's
yes,
me gay! Get
touch
off
him.
Me! Oh, he's touching! Oh, he's sucking my nipple! Oh! Why couldn't it be Gwen? Why did it be the...
I'm not allowed to touch you. What are you talking about?
I know, but better than a homosexual,
dude. Can I
touch
dude. You
yet? Yeah, why don't you suck my nipple? Come on, Gwen.
As a representative of the homosexual community, I salute you. I'm so glad that you're alive today because yeah. you're a credit to the non-homosexuals.
Thank you.
This is a little homosexual plaything. This is a sex toy I brought
wow.
you, and these
oh,
are some homosexual
job.
Music.
We know what that means.
Yes.
The toy.
We know what job means, don't we?
Yeah. It's something we don't
you
have.
You want to yeah. give me a
you got
hand?
It. Yeah, yeah. Push
Run.
The button.
Want to give me a hand? I'm sure you're real good at it, practicing 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Well, yes.
Life.
As a matter of
right,
fact,
right, right.
I am.
Hand?
Yes,
as a matter
indeed.
Of fact, he is.
Come
I am.
Come on, buddy.
Yes.
You know, do it right
do
now.
You, do you do,
you
do it
right
with
now?
The one or do you do the two?
No. Oh,
Wait.
No,
I,
no, no.
Rod,
I can't go
I can't
that.
Conduct an interview like this. My mother's here. Come on.
Oh,
be a little
my
bit.
God.
Come on. Be nice. My mother's here. Ashley, she's probably not here anymore.
Well, as you know, we homosexuals, we like our mothers and all mothers very much, and I apologize for anything that I've done that has upset any mother or anywhere
well,
offended
see,
any of
the
them.
Out of
a lot of people out there
out.
Are pissed off at you because they think of me as, you know, a heterosexual icon. And
because
to see you aggressively
being, yes,
you know, assaulting
yes,
me,
I know.
A lot of
I
my fans, it's just like,
up.
It's just, Ron, it's just like when Hugh Hefner and Pete Townshend both admitted they had bisexual, I mean, they had homosexual experiences, and then you couldn't trust them as studs
bisexual,
anymore.
You went, but here,
you
let's have the bisexual.
Yeah, make that one quick, let's see that. Yeah, this is good.
Oh,
getting close on this. Sex. Now, wasn't that better than that guy you're with?
God, yes. What was I thinking? Oh, I feel. Oh my
you
God, I made a horrible mistake with my entire life.
I know, all of your whole life.
Six rules. Oh man, thank you, Greg.
No problem,
oh.
buddy. Like,
wow.
Ron.
Oh, I'm sorry, I touched you.
Check this.
Oh.
Check
thank
this out.
So
this is gonna be perfect.
Yeah.
We're gonna. You're gonna. Gwen's gonna move in with you.
Yeah.
And then your boyfriend moves in with her boyfriend in Ellicottville. His
yeah.
name's Doug Bush. It's
Ooh,
perfect!
I love
Doug
it!
Doug Bush, come on!
Love
yeah.
it!
All right,
yes.
Thanks, no, have a good night.
No. I'm sorry, but I have to catch a plane.
I don't think he'll go for that.
Let's go. Let's go. We don't have any time left.
Yeah.
There's no time left. Oh, I guess we got left. Oh, my God. Gretchen Schultz. Oh, now we do the regular conversation with Gretchen Schultz. Okay, here we go. Regular conversation, Gwen.
Greg.
But I remember.
Okay, everyone pretend to be regular now because Gretchen Schultz superstars on the show. Okay, here we go. Ready? Gwen, let's start over like we're real normal and sedate, okay?
Okay.
But I remember on the show that I was on, I thought you thought that Gwen was a man. So really, everything's okay.
Oh, that's right, Ron. That's why.
Because oh, now I understand, of course.
That's why
Gwen
I changed
Gwen is a man. No wonder Ron enjoyed
Gretchen
kissing her.
Remember
I
that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah,
you
good keep point, Gretchen. That's why you're a superstar.
Because yeah, she's so smart.
Insight.
So, except I'm not a man. That's the only problem. I keep trying
Gretchen,
to.
Gretchen, do you want to kiss Greg Gwen and see if she's a man? Because it'd probably be good for you because you're heterosexual and she's a man. And let's.
Greg,
okay,
why don't you kiss everybody?
I have a fiance. I just got engaged. You want me to kiss some other woman with my fiance
no,
in the room?
Do that.
God damn it all.
That's right.
Have some class.
She's wearing
Gretchen,
red.
It's great to have you on.
You guys are.
I really enjoy your music.
They just
and your
got
work
engaged on the show.
Yeah. Last night I asked my.
What are you thinking?
My love, Paula. What do you mean, what is she thinking?
That's what I said. I said, here comes a bride all dressed in red.
Are you trying
red
to say I'm not
oh
good?
Oh my God, she's going to marry
Are you trying
Greg
to say I'm not good?
No.
So you're trying to say I'm good. Well, it's nice having you on. It's real. You look good.
Thanks a lot.
How's your tour going?
Tour's going good.
That's good.
Better
are the fans responding to you? I hear you have a video set up behind you now with special video screens.
Yeah, she's doing a documentary, like the Madonna thing, except it's called Gretchen Schultz
Live.
No,
that's a rumor, but it's a good one.
Yeah.
I heard that you also have the Canadian Mounted Police on a tour with you. Is that true?
Yeah, man. Okay, from Samoa.
What about did you secretly marry David Geffen in a ceremony in Las Vegas?
What are you talking about?
Oh, I'm just asking about the stuff I read about in Rolling Stone. Come on, get out my back.
The truth of the matter is, Gretchen, that Greg has decided to not have any facts
Gretchen,
on this show.
You know, I'd like to talk to you more.
Except for marriage.
I appreciate someone as big as you coming here and being here for my birthday. But we got so many goddamn guests left, and there's no time.
Later.
You were so good, though.
Thanks, Gretchen.
You were so good. You're so damn good.
Happy
who's
birthday
left? My father. You're my goddamn father in here.
Oh, Jesus no,
Christ,
right
time
now.
Right now.
Oh,
we're
done.
We're dead. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. John Lombardo's here.
I'm changing.
Oh, my God.
I've been wrong all these years.
Oh, my God. First Gretchen Schultz about John Lombardo. Where's Ben Ronald? Oh, there he is. Okay, you got the.
I'm feeling it.
Oh, thanks for being here. A big superstar.
John, everybody's attacking me.
This guy has played in Yugoslavia, Serbia. Am I right?
No.
Manchester. Hungary. You played in Hungary?
China.
Greece. Kosovo.
Greece, right?
No.
Greece, New York?
I played in Irondakoy.
Wow.
Irondakoy,
wow. Walt Disney World, you played at too, right?
Yeah.
We're getting all these.
So, you know, it's wow, this is amazing. A big star.
People.
First Gretchen Schultz.
Well, what birthday is it? What number?
34. Yeah, it's all over now, baby blue.
Wow.
It's all downhill from now on. Is this a special hour episode?
Yeah.
We're running out of time. How many guests we got left?
Yeah.
How many guests we have left?
Oh, there's a line like all the way out.
They're going out the street.
We've already got.
Well, we better do two shows.
So bring them all in at my feet then, except for my father. Get them all here at my feet. I'm not kidding. Get them in here at my feet, Paula.
It's guest
time. Except for my father. No, well, John, you know.
It's Pam! Oh my God!
Pam, all right.
All right.
This is wild.
Now everybody,
Ben Rado reunion.
The Ben Rado reunion. And our new bassist.
New bassist.
Our new bassist, John Lombardo.
Guitar, Pam Schwartz. Drums, Ben Ronald.
Ben Ronald.
All right.
Assistant
Amanda,
vocals.
You're gonna get a little song for us now.
Gwen.
You're gonna do a little song for us now. What? We have to get the dance in, yeah. Who is left? Is that it? Where's my father?
He's right here.
Dad, I just want to say
Dad's
that
here.
Thanks for being here. What do you have to say?
Go ahead. Go ahead. 2 seconds. Just talk.
Just keep talking. Okay, here's the dance. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Clap.